souls. And this is why St. Bernadette's Legion of Mary members have dedicated to educate others of the extraordinary power of our Blessed Virgin Mary by reciting the Rosary. Thank you for being here to recite the Rosary. And now we begin to recite the Apostle Creed. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffering under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell on hell, the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and
at the hour of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be,
world without end. The first joyful mystery is the Annunciation. The angel Gabriel tells Mary that she is to be the Mother of God. The fruit of the mystery is humility. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
sinners,
now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory to our Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. The second joyful mystery is the visitation. The Blessed Virgin makes a visit to her cousin Elizabeth. The fruit of the mystery is love of neighbor. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, because we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
sinners,
now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and
shall
ever be, world
without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. The third joyful mystery is the Nativity. The infant Jesus is born in the stable at Bethlehem. The fruit of the mystery is poverty and spirit. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,
world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fourth joyful mystery is the presentation. The Blessed Virgin presents the child Jesus to Simeon in the temple. The fruit of the mystery is obedience. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. My Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. The fifth joyful mystery, the finding in the temple. Jesus is lost for 3 days, and the Blessed Mother finds him in the temple. The fruit of the mystery is joy in finding Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for
us
sinners, now and at the
hour of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
sinners,
now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at
the hour of our death. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sin, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, O man and children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thy eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile shall come to the blessed truth of thy name, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of salvation life, grant we beseech thee that meditating upon these mysteries of the Holy Rosary, of the most holy Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Queen of the most holy Rosary, pray for us. O Mary, conceived without sin, who has recourse to thee. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you.
Joseph, please stand. Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the solemnity of the Holy Trinity. God is the mystery of God. So, God revealed to us the mystery of love in order to share with us eternal life. So as we gather here today before the table of the Lord, to open ourselves to listen to His eternal word and to be fed by His body, by body. Thus humbly bow down ourselves, asking God to sanctify us with the Holy Spirit. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have forgiven sin in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most serious fault. Therefore, as Blessed Mary and Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy.
Thank you.
God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, make known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful and majesty. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, "If I find favor with you, O Lord, you come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sin, and receive us as your own." Word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world may be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but in our daily lives, at work or at home, sometimes we experience some tough day, right? Nothing's worked out for us. Everything seems like a ruin. So, and then we try to blame on someone or blame on everything around us. Instead of sitting down and reflecting on our inability, our limitations, but we don't do that, but then we try to blame that on someone. Because that blaming game that exists from the beginning, right? When God, in Genesis, the book of Genesis, God comes to ask Eve, first woman, so have you eaten the fruit? And Eve, what did he do? He answered, because of the snake that took me into life. And then God asked Adam, did you eat the fruit? Because of the woman that you gave me. So that blaming game that happened from the beginning. So that's why we try to blame on other people, even though that's our fault, right? So we try to understand the surrounding of us. Sometimes we cannot understand it. Sometimes it does not make sense. So, if we cannot understand the surrounding of the nature or our limitations, how can we try to understand the mystery of God, our love?
God. And today we celebrate the Solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. One God in three persons. One God in three persons. How can it be? It's kind of complicated. How can one God in three persons? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So if you try to understand that mystery, then you are someone else, something else. So there's a story, a legend story, talking about Saint Augustine in the year 1415. He was working on the beach after a long day, working on the dogma. He tried to understand the mystery of the Holy Trinity. So after a long day of trying to figure out what is this about, so he took a look and he saw a little boy with a shell. The little boy tried to get all the water from the ocean to that little hole somewhere next to the ocean. He went back and forth. And Saint Augustine came to the little boy asking, "So what are you trying to do, my son?" And that little boy answered, "Well, I tried to get all the water in the oceans into this hole." And Saint Augustine said, "It's impossible. How can it be? Can you see the ocean? That's the great ocean, a lot of water. So how can it fit into this little hole?" And the boy answered, "Well, I think I can be able to do that before you can figure out the mystery of the Holy Trinity." And when that boy answered that question, he disappeared. And some said that maybe some angels tried to appear and teach Saint Augustine a lesson, or Jesus himself tried to teach Saint Augustine a lesson. And the story of the mystery of God, one God in three persons. Maybe it's complicated. Maybe for us it's easier to understand that just one God, in person. Father created the universe, Jesus Christ, the second person in the Trinity, was sent into our human history because of love. And the Holy Spirit, the third person in the Trinity, has sanctified the church and sent it into the church by Jesus Christ, the second person in the Trinity. So each of them are distinguished, but yet one God, share the same love. The Father loved the Son, and the Son received God's love and loved him in return. And that love between the Father and the Son generated the Holy Spirit. So dear friends, what should we get out of this? Mystery of God's love, the Holy Trinity. The one thing that we would and we should understand is that God tried to reveal this mystery to us in order to share His love with us. God shared His love with us by revealing this mystery to us. Even though the Bible did not talk about that so much, or the church did not teach about that so much. So if we try to understand that, we don't have the power to support us. But we should understand that God revealed this mystery to us is not to fulfill our curiosity, it's not about that, but to share His love with His creation, His people. So He wants to bring us home, eternal home with Him. He wants to show us the way back to eternal home. So we know that Jesus, as in today's gospel, we heard that because He loved us so much that He sent His Son into the world so that He's not coming to condemn the world, but to save us from our sins. And if we are as children, we should learn to imitate this love of the Holy Trinity, which means that in any families, the foundations that each family should build on is like the foundation of love. Love is the foundation of the family. And each of us should imitate on the love of the Holy Trinity to make that love become the foundation of our daily life, our families. That's love and unity that make our families strong. So dear friends, if we learn and imitate in this mystery of God's love, then the first reading said, God, slow to anger, rich in kindness and fidelity, which we imitate in that slow to anger, rich in kindness to our brothers and sisters. And we also learn from Moses to please God for other people's sin, to please to forgive our brothers and sisters' faults. And the second reading, the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, saying that if we have peace of God, if we love, then the peace of God will be in our heart. So dear friends, the Holy Trinity is the mystery that we cannot understand, or we cannot explain using logic language or rational language. But we do understand that God loves us to the point that He's sending His Son into our world to redeem us from our sins, to lead us back to eternal hope that God has prepared for each of us. May God bless each of us.
It's valuable, that's our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, but successful to the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, we come down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was the government of the Virgin Mary, and became a man. For our faith, crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered at death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, and for the resurrection. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God. We will not be in our order to judge the living. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord of the Lord of life, who is the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord and the Word of God, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church, and the Testament of baptism and forgiveness of sins.
As we strive to grow in greater relationship with each other and our Creator and build up a community of life and love, we raise our prayers to the God of relationship.
For the Church, that she may be a living sacrament of God's Trinitarian love and the sign of God's covenant with God's people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. For the shepherds of our church, that they will reflect the compassionate and forgiving love of the Trinity for those most in need of compassion and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the people of God, that they will live in peace and harmony, reflecting the loving relationship of the three persons, one God, who live together in loving communion. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the leaders of our nation and world, that they will seek to resolve conflicts peacefully and work together to create a more just and humane world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
All those who have graduated this year, may the Lord continue to guide them as they start a new chapter in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who now sleep in the presence of Christ, especially Cy and Melda Wiggy, for whom this Mass is offered, may they enjoy the promise of the resurrection through the power of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God Almighty and love, hear these prayers and answer them according to your holy will, that we may continue to grow in communion with you and with your creation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It should invite and just alluded in our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confession of true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity of substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim. We never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice, they claim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We offer the Lord the bread of life and the chalice of salvation.
giving thanks that it held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Have a look right at partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread by the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Give us Francis our Pope and Myron our Bishop for the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of destruction and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your grace. Have mercy on us, we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may in this beautiful age of eternal life may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Save from the trust as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, when you said to your apostles, peace I give you, may peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace to be God of peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's not wish to the sun.
Behold him, take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who come to the supper of the Lord.
Lord,
an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I can't at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually in my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you again. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Merciful Sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess the eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So we know that we are at the beginning of June, right? So which means that most of you, those who are students, may graduate this year. So do we have any graduates in the house? Can you raise your hands? So please come forward. We have a blessing for you. All those graduates, please come forward.
Special, all right, you are the special person.
So invite you and the community to please, you can sit down and join me to raise your right hand and we'll pray for
Jamie.
So we pray for you, we have a blessing for you. Before you were even formed, God knew you. While in your mother's womb, God named you. At your birth, God filled you with life. Today, we celebrate what you have become at this moment in time. And so we pray. God of our beginning, we thank you for the gifts of the graduates, their excitement, the awesome wonder and curiosity, the open speech and encouraging words, the contributions that bless and challenge us, and we have become a richer and more diverse community because of them. As we step forward into the world that awaits, comfort their fears with the full knowledge of your divine presence. Strengthen the resolve to walk in the footsteps of Jesus as modern day disciples in a world that needs their spirit. Guide the faith as they move through life, protecting them from the pitfalls of darkness while they help to lead future generations into the value and promise of your light. We ask this blessing upon the graduates in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So, this is the gift from the parish. Even if the rosary, this is a rosary which given to you, so that asking you to pray for yourself and for the community, too, right? So God bless you.
Thank you.
Health and Charity for Health Fresh Healthy Living is presenting a free Eat Healthy, Be Active workshop on Thursdays from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. in the hall. Please pick up a flyer in the vestibule for more information. Everyone is invited to celebrate Father Delphine's 20th ordination anniversary on Saturday, June 17th. Please RSVP in the office. Hope to see you. We invite everyone to come and enjoy a free concert by our very own St. Bernadette's Music Ministry on Thursday, June 22nd at 7 p.m. Donations will go towards the purchase of our very own new piano. Remember, Vacation Bible School will be back the last week of June. Watch for signups. And if you would like to support our parish with an ad in your business, of your business in our bulletin, please call the parish office for a meeting.
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. I am Julius Ferro with the Knights of Columbus, 4th degree, past district deputy, and fraternal insurance benefit advisor. First and foremost, my gratitude to Father Joseph for allowing me to do this public announcement for our annual insurance drive of the Knights of Columbus to all the masses today and tomorrow. Did you know that the Knights of Columbus Insurance Program is the highest rated nonprofit life insurance company in the United States, and it is exclusive only to Catholic families? Our founder, the Blessed Father Michael McGivney, soon to be canonized as saint, started the Knights of Columbus in 1882, that was 141 years ago, with the primary goal of providing Catholic families with the best financial protection possible, which is even embedded in our charter. It is our not-for-profit insurance program that offers various products to meet your personal goals, like long-term care, fixed annuities, disability, and life insurance benefits. The most important difference that sets the Knights of Columbus apart from other companies is our investment strategy. We only invest in companies that follow the teachings of the church, and if you are concerned that your money will not be used to support Planned Parenthood, abortion, pornography, or anything else outside the teachings of the church, and only to be invested in companies with Catholic ideals, then you need to choose to do business with the Knights of Columbus, a pedigree with a unique Catholic purpose. That's the reason why we are here today, to continue with that novel mission. Last year, I was privileged to have more than 73 families, that's families, not individuals, and it was indeed a blessing. That's why I was the top-rated fraternal insurance agent for the year 2022 in our agency, notwithstanding that it was my first year, simply because I worked hard to meet one's specific needs. And it is indeed my passion helping others, especially my fellow Catholic brothers and sisters, with their families like all of you here today. So, to learn more and discover the Catholic difference, see us after the Mass outside the church by the blue table, and we also have blessed rosaries for giveaways. And if interested to meet with me and take advantage of this worthy benefit, just simply sign up in our table with your name and phone number, and we will call you for an appointment to perform a complimentary or finished analysis with you in order to determine and personalize your needs. Thank you for listening. And thank you again, Father, and for your information, Father, also, and Father, Fidel, our members of the Knights of Columbus. May God bless you all. Viva Jesus. Thank you.
The Lord be with you. So may God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thank you.
And have a blessed weekend.
Thank you.